This morning, give for the kids. Donations roll in for the Royal Children's Hospital. The holiday rush underway, one of Melbourne Airport's busiest times of year. And what next for Jack Crisp? The Magpies head home from Brisbane after their first loss of the season.
This is 7 News with Blake Johnson.
Good morning. For the 92nd year, Victorians are digging deep to raise money for the Royal Children's Hospital. Fundraising is underway right across the state. Christy Mayer leads our coverage from Appeal headquarters at the Melbourne Exhibition and Convention Centre. Good morning, Christy. This is a very special day.
Oh, it certainly is, Blake, and so special to see so many people out so early this morning supporting this incredible cause. As you can see behind me, Appeal is well underway here at the Melbourne Convention and Exhibition Centre with the Kids Day Out in full swing. This is a jam-packed event with face painting, carnival rides, live music, singing and dancing. Kids everywhere here are having the absolute time of their lives. The teddy bears are getting a full check-up here today at the Teddy Bear Hospital. And this is just one of many ways that you can support the Good Friday Appeal today. It's raising money for the kids.
From intersections in the suburbs to Melbourne Airport, to country Victoria, the sounds of tin rattlers defines Good Friday in this state.
Thank you very much. Have a great weekend.
Across Victoria, the race is on to pass last year's $22 million total. Thanks, 2-year-old Arlo and 6-year-old Aru are the faces of this year's Good Friday appeal.
When we found out that we were really thrilled and it's happening and we are so excited.
More than 100,000 people are expected to descend on the annual Kids Day Out here at the Melbourne Convention and Exhibition Centre. Among the ways to raise money for a small donation, kids can have their soft toys attended to at the Teddy Bear Hospital.
To all our volunteers around the state, all the tin shakers on the street corners which I saw this morning, the people volunteering here in the Teddy Bear Hospital, the kids day out here at the Convention Centre, we've got the footy on, we've got the amazing telethon on Channel 7 tonight, we've got so much going on today and we just hope that everybody gives as much as they can.
A day of family fun, raising funds to keep Victoria's Royal Children's Hospital ahead of the game for our littlest patients.
And we are hearing that more than $650,000 has already been raised. So an incredible effort so far, but of course we do have a long way to go if we are going to beat the $22 million that was raised last year. There are plenty of ways that you can show your support at home. Everyone is ready to take your phone calls. The number to call is 1300-APPEAL, or you can visit the website, that's goodfridayappeal.com.au. Blake.
Off to a great start. Christy, thank you. The Easter holiday rush is underway. Travellers are filing through Melbourne Airport this morning. Tegan Dolling, it's one of the airport's most hectic times of year.
Good morning, Blake. The Easter exodus is well and truly underway. It's been incredibly busy at Melbourne Airport this morning. Luckily, not too many delays or big queues here in the security lines, and it's because the airlines and the airport have put on extra staff to deal with all these passengers. There's actually 2.1 million passengers that'll be through the terminals over the Easter long weekend. It makes it the busiest weekend since before the pandemic. Now, it seems a lot of the travellers are heading up north. They're wanting to escape this freezing cold Easter that we're about to shiver through. A lot of people heading up to the Gold Coast and even the Sunny Coast. Unfortunately, Virgin did cancel a flight up to Cairns this morning, meaning that some people have had to re-look at their Easter plans.
We went to put our check in the automatic thing and flight cancelled. So now they're saying with Virgin there's nothing. There's nothing else until... No, there's nothing until Monday.
Yeah, we're hopping along to Cairns until our flight got cancelled like 5 minutes before the flight.
And we all came 4 o'clock and it's a big family and they cancel on us.
So a lot of very excited kids currently on their way up to their holidays, some even holidaying for the first time in a couple of years. And don't worry, I've been told that the Easter Bunny will be able to find you even if you are going away for the holidays.
A gunman remains on the loose after a shooting in Melbourne's northwest. Crime reporter Cassie Zervos has the latest. Cassie, the victim is not in a good way.
Well, Blake, the victim underwent emergency surgery last night after he was shot to his lower body. 7 News understands he suffered significant injuries to one of his legs and now is at risk of amputation. Emergency services were called to a home on Meadowview Way in Canley yesterday afternoon after neighbours reported hearing several gunshots. Police say the gunman left the scene in a red four-wheel drive but crashed just a few streets away and fled on foot. He was last seen hiding in a shopping centre car park. Armed Crime Squad detectives are leading this investigation and are appealing to anyone with information as the manhunt continues to find the violent offender. Blake.
Cassie Servos with the latest from the newsroom. 2 teenagers have been arrested after a woman was stabbed to death in Abbotsford on Wednesday. The boys were caught near Ballarat after a statewide manhunt that lasted 15 hours. One is 15, accused of killing his mother with the help of his 14-year-old friend. The pair was driven back to Melbourne last night to be interviewed. Police have not laid charges. A driver has died after losing control behind the wheel and crashing into a tree near Bendigo. Police believe the car came off Holdsworth Road in White Hills, smashing into the tree and bursting into flames just after 3 a.m. No one else was injured. It comes as police plead with Victorians to take care on our roads this long weekend. Their Operation Nexus is underway, ramping up police presence, particularly on country roads, over the next 4 days. Nearby residents have described hearing a loud bang when a small plane crash-landed into trees south of Brisbane this morning. As Jordan Bissell reports, somehow the pilot was able to walk away from the wreckage.
Good morning. The pilot, a woman in her 30s, managed to walk away from the crash behind me with just minor injuries. She'd taken off from Bankstown Airport and was flying to Archerfield just a few kilometres away when she was forced to make an emergency landing just after 6 o'clock this morning. Residents nearby heard what sounded like a car hitting trees before the plane crashed along the rail corridor in Hillcrest.
I saw that the front of the aeroplane had crashed
and was just like taking out trees and branches as it was going past. We live a couple of hundred metres up the road. We just walked down and just saw the plane there in the front of it missing and a helicopter come in.
The plane belongs to a medevac company. It's believed the woman had been trying to get up her flying hours. The craft had made the same trip in reverse in the early hours of this morning, flying from Archerfield to Bankstown before turning around and taking off again to fly back to southeast Queensland when the emergency landing happened. The woman has been taken to Logan Hospital in a stable condition with just minor injuries.
Up next in 7 News, church services underway as Christians mark the most solemn day on the calendar as the royals mark the occasion in the UK. And the owner of a Melbourne burger restaurant takes his stoush with Kanye West to America. As we take a look at the Good Friday Appeal phone room, you're watching a special edition of 7 News live from Melbourne.
Three bright, beautiful young women vanished from the streets of Claremont.
Someone out there knows who it is.
It's just your worst fear.
But the man who abducted them is still out there.
The third young woman to disappear from Claremont.
We have to get him for Sarah.
We might have a living witness.
The unmissable drama event. The Claremont Murders premieres Easter Monday, 8:30 on 7 and 7 Plus.
Supercoat dogs live their best life because Supercoat is made with our very own smart blend of high quality ingredients plus 22 essential vitamins and minerals, nourishing dogs to be at their best. Supercoat.
You hate wasting money, right? Then what's this? You could switch health insurance easily. Remember,
keep your eye on the wheel.
Switching health insurance is easy with Compare the Market. Simples.
11 essential vitamins and minerals, low GI, protein.
It's amazing what they squeeze into an up and go.
We squeeze more good stuff in, so you can get more out. Also available in up and go protein.
It's on this Saturday, the JCar huge Easter Saturday sale. 20% off nearly everything in store. 20% off tech, workbench equipment, cables, connectors and more. One day only, don't miss it. The JCar huge Easter Saturday sale. Over 100 stores nationwide.
international smash hit Mother Africa in a thrilling display of African culture and talent. Mother Africa, but now.
Got a gut, yeah, shake it off, oh yeah. Got a gut,
shake it off, yes you can, with the man shake.
Got a gut, shake it off.
Primo Bacon, far beyond flavour. Quality ingredients, traditionally smoked and cured. There's good, there's great, and then there is Primo.
You hit the ground, here, where a leaking fridge turned the aisle to ice. Here's the physical and financial pain, and your partner who becomes your carer. Here's the job you can't do for 3 months. If you ever find yourself here, turn to Slater and Gordon. We make it easier to get the compensation you need to move forward in life. Take the Slater and Gordon free claim check, and we'll take it from here.
As we go to where church services are taking place across the city as Christians mark the most solemn day on their religious calendar. The Hillsong community gathered at Festival Hall for two services this morning, using music to mark Good Friday. Hundreds of Christians were also at St Patrick's Cathedral and St Paul's to mark the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. Archbishop Peter Comensoli's Easter message is about healing after a tough 12 months. Cracks are appearing in the Federal Liberal Party after its rejection of an Aboriginal voice to Parliament. Former Indigenous Affairs Minister Ken Wyatt has quit the party in disgust. Live to Rob Scott in Canberra. Rob, bad news for Peter Dutton, but the political fallout may have only just begun.
Yeah, looks like it, Blake. Ken Wyatt's decision to walk away from the party that he served for decades emphasises just how disappointed and disillusioned he is with its decision not to back the voice to Parliament. He's no longer a member of Parliament after losing his seat at the last election, but Mr Wyatt was the first Indigenous person to be elected to the House of Representatives, and he's still very widely respected. His resignation is no doubt a blow for the Liberals. He said it was a tough decision for him to make, but that he no longer believes in what the Liberals have become after Peter Dutton announced that the party would campaign against the voice to Parliament, a model that he actually helped to formulate as part of the referendum working group. Labor says that his decision to abandon the Liberals is just another sign that the opposition under Peter Dutton is being driven by cynical politics.
The sad fact is the Liberal Party under Peter Dutton now looks more like Pauline Hanson than Robert Menzies. I do think, Nat, that they may have reached a different conclusion if Josh Frydenberg was still there.
Ken is a great friend, a former colleague. You won't hear me say a bad word about him. It's sad that he's come to this decision.
That's Ken's prerogative. You don't always get what you want when you're in a political party. I think it shows that Peter Dutton and his party room took a principal position as the National Party did 6 months ago.
Despite other members of Parliament, like Tasmania's Bridget Archer, openly saying that they will go against the party position, crossing the floor to support the voice, Peter Dutton insists that his party is united and that 99% of his colleagues agree that the voice will make no difference to the lives of Indigenous Australians. Like
Rob Scott there in Canberra, thank you. Three members of a Sydney family have survived their house collapsing around them early this morning. It happened around 5 o'clock. Firefighters roped off the area as further collapse is possible. It's understood the house had undergone recent construction, and incredibly, the three people inside were able to get out uninjured before the home crumbled. Tensions are escalating in the Middle East this morning, with Israeli warplanes reportedly carrying out several air raids in Gaza. There's no word yet on casualties or who was the intended target. It follows the firing of several rockets into Israel, which in turn appears to be a response to Israeli police raids on Jerusalem's Al-Aqsa Mosque this week. The woman at the centre of Donald Trump's current legal woes has given a tell-all interview. Adult film star Stormy Daniels has spoken about her alleged affair with the former US president, which has landed him in court.
He had to go in and be under the rule of someone else. He had to obey the judge and walk through like a, you know, the king has been dethroned. He's no longer untouchable. Mm. And nobody should be untouchable. It doesn't matter if what your job description is, whether you're the president, like, you should be held responsible for your actions.
Trump is due back in court in December. King Charles has taken part in a centuries-old Easter tradition. The monarch handed out special coins during the Royal Maundy service. Here's our Europe Bureau Chief, Hugh Whitfeld.
Maundy Thursday, part of Holy Week in the run-up to Easter. And this is a tradition that dates back at least 800 years, continued by King Charles at York Minster overnight, where coins are handed to members of the public as a sign of charity from the Crown. In recent years, particularly during Her Late Majesty's reign, it has been pensioners who have received the coins, and the number of coins handed out relates to the monarch's age. Charles is 74, so 74 men and 74 women received what were commemorative coins, so unfortunately they can't go and spend that money. Members of the royal family, we are told by the palace, will be at Windsor Castle for Easter Sunday, the first Easter for Charles since his accession to the throne. They'll be attending an Easter Sunday service at St George's Chapel at Windsor Castle. It'll be the first time since 2019 that a monarch will attend such a service, owing to COVID and, in more recent years, the late Queen's failing health.
Victorians are digging deep for the Good Friday appeal. Sharnel Vella is with the Premier now, who's making a big donation on behalf of taxpayers.
Good morning, Blake. I am joined by Premier Daniel Andrews. You've come with a very special donation.
$1 million on behalf of all Victorians, Sharnel, because the Royal Children's Hospital has got a special place in the hearts of every single Victorian. Two of our kids have been patients at the Royal Children's Hospital and were taken, you know, such great care was taken of them. Look, at the end of the day, I think all of us know that it's a great comfort to think that we've got not just a good paediatric hospital, but the very best paediatric hospital anywhere in the world available for kids and families to change lives and save lives every single day. This is a really important cause today, and I know Victorians will dig deep.
It is especially hard for Victorians at the moment, but do you still think they'll find it in their hearts to give to this magnificent hospital?
I think people are very, very generous. And the other thing people know is that even a small amount of money makes a really big difference. So I'm confident that we'll get over that $22 million mark, 22.3 last year. So hopefully it'll be 22.4 or more. And on behalf of all Victorians, that $1 million contribution in recognition of just how worthy the cause is, but also in recognition that Victorians are doing it tough at the moment with interest rates and the cost of living. It's a really important thing for us to do.
Thank you so much for your time. There we go, $1 million from the Andrews government. Blake.
Good stuff, Sharnel. Thank you. A Melbourne burger shop owner who was stood up in court by Kanye West is going to extreme lengths to track down the rap star. Mark El-Khoury has flown to the US to find Kanye and ask him to pay up outstanding legal costs after the rapper's bid to sue him was dismissed. El-Khoury was left out of pocket when the rapper was a no-show in the federal court last month after the star accused the Ivanhoe Burger Joint of using his image without permission. He's currently in Los Angeles posting to his Instagram account, "I'm here, Kanye, call me." Sport is next with Andrew McCormack, including what's next for Pies head home after their first loss of the season, and the phones are ringing for the Good Friday appeal. You're watching a special edition of Seven's Morning News live from Melbourne.
Exciting new dishes from one of the biggest recipe websites in Australia.
Let's see what Joe thinks.
Oh, it's exceptional.
New Better Homes tonight.
It's all around us, no need to look far.
Cherish those golden to us this Easter. Fragrant hazelnuts, smooth, velvety chocolate. Say it with gold. Ferrero Rocher.
You hit the ground, here, where a leaking fridge turned the aisle to ice. Here's the physical and financial pain, and your partner who becomes your carer. Here's the job you can't do for 3 months. If you ever find yourself here, turn to Slater and Gordon. We make it easier to get the compensation you need to move forward in life. Take the Slater and Gordon free claim check, and we'll take it from here.
On the Origin Everyday Rewards plan, you'll get rewarded for everyday energy use. We've given away over 3 billion everyday rewards points so far. Just another way good value never stops at Origin, where all good change starts.
Franklin Lightly Sparkling. Feel fizzing good.
Playing an instant scratch-its ticket is so exciting. It feels like being blown from a rainbow fun cannon through clouds pink and fluffy. There's no time like scratchy time with instant scratch-its.
Harvey Norman's Super Easter Sale, on now. Save $150 on this HP 14-inch laptop. Now super value at under $400. Get a bonus Galaxy Watch 4 valued at $399 with the awesome new Samsung Galaxy A34. Save $200 on the versatile Dyson V8 Stick Vac. Plus, get a bonus $50 gift card. Now only $594. Save $200 on this energy-efficient Westinghouse fridge. Now only $994. On now at Harvey Norman. Ends Monday.
Are you concerned about stretch marks during pregnancy? Try Bio Oil Skincare Oil, now $24.99 from Chemist Warehouse. It's clinically proven to help improve the appearance of scars and stretch marks. Live, look, feel fabulous at Chemist Warehouse.
Good morning. Collingwood insists a controversial build-up had nothing to do with its first loss of the season. The Pies will continue to support Jack Crisp as they make their way back home from Brisbane.
Good morning. Well, the Magpies are due home shortly from Brisbane after dropping their first game of the season last night, a 33-point loss to the Lions. The big talking point, that of star midfielder Jack Crisp, currently under investigation and due to meet with the AFL next week after a leaked video circulated online in the lead-up to the game against the Lions. His coach, Craig McRae, refusing to blame the controversy as a distraction for the result.
Yeah, I'm not going to comment on what's going on with it. And in terms of Jack, it's like every player on our list, we love and support them and 100% got their back. There's lots of stuff that goes on within our players that I'm not always going to condone. I'm a father and I don't always condone with the things my kids do. But at the end of the day, we love and support them and that's not going to change.
It was Collingwood's first game without a recognised ruckman that will become a big focus over the next month before ruckman Darcy Cameron returns from injury. Lions forward Charlie Cameron, the match winner, 6 majors for the home side. The Pies, though, now will have an extended break before their next game, a 10-day lapse before they face St Kilda in Adelaide. For Gather Round. This afternoon, it's North Melbourne and Carlton at Marvel Stadium, a sellout for Good Friday footy, arguably the biggest Good Friday clash to date. You can catch that match right here on the screens of Seven.
Thanks, Mitch. Mitch Cleary there. A rampaging Melbourne Storm has proven too good for the Sydney Roosters. Victorious 28-8 at Amy Park. Rooster star Victor Radley was sin-binned after a late shot on Cameron Munster. It didn't faze the Storm superstar, who was brilliant in attack, along with Xavier Coates, who finished with a hat-trick.
The only way we could get beat if we beat ourselves, you know. And so we had that good lead and we, you know, I thought we'd done a really good job in hanging on to that.
Storm are now sitting second on the NRL ladder. Adam Scott and Jason Day have reignited hopes of an Australian triumph at the Masters after career-best performances in the opening round. Scott's bid for a second green jacket started with a 4-under 67. He's in a tie for sixth after his first sub-70 start since 2019. Day hold a clutch par putt on the last to close out a bogey-free 67. He's tied for fourth, 2 shots off the lead.
It's nice to be able to get off to a good start, but you know, you can't get too far ahead of yourself. It might end up turning into a marathon if we have a pretty, you know, wet, kind of windy conditions on the weekend.
Victor Hovland, John Rahm and Brooks Koepka lead at 7-under. Bad weather is looming, though, at Augusta. And a place among the greats awaits Australia's Group 1 horse Animo when the 4-year-old races in the $5 million Queen Elizabeth Stakes. Animo gets a chance to equal the legendary mare Winx's record for most wins in a season tomorrow at Royal Randwick.
He's going really well. He hasn't put a foot wrong, so hopefully we can in this Australian campaign with a winner.
Day two of the championships is live and free on Seven. Also live and free, of course, the footy this arvo will be a great, great clash, a sellout, probably the biggest ever Good Friday match, really. So it should be a cracker from 4 o'clock this arvo.
Macca, thank you very much. Let's check in now. The Good Friday appeal. Seven News reporter Paul Dowsley is in the phone room. Paul, g'day to you.
Hey, Blake, this is like the epicentre, one of the great traditions of the Royal Children's Hospital Good Friday Appeal. The phone room, and it's full of people ready to take your calls. Give everyone a wave. Big waves. So some of the remote on calls typing information. I'm up in the back row, but we want to go down to meet Maria, who is in the second row here. And Maria took a call from a young boy, and I want to talk to you about it. Thank you to Charnel Veller, our state political reporter, who's helping here behind the scenes. Maria, good morning.
Good morning.
What a great job you're doing taking calls.
Thank you.
Now, you took a call from a young man, boy. What did he tell you was his motivation?
Well, it was a nine-year-old little boy called Hudson. He broke his femur, and they flew him down to the Royal Children's Hospital in Melbourne. And while he was confined to a wheelchair, he thought he'd put it to good use and raise some money for all the other children. So he did 20 laps around the corridors, 48 kilometres, and he raised $6,770.
$6,000 from a nine-year-old.
Yeah,
he's a
champion.
Isn't that great?
Really great.
Kids looking after kids. So that's one of the stories we're hearing here in the phone room. Please ring in. Who knows the phone number? Who knows it? Oh, go, here we go. What's the phone number to ring and speak with us?
1 second, I'll just look it up.
Oh, geez, too long, Dale. You get one shot. 1-300-277-325. You missed your big chance on the tally. Back to you, Blake.
Lucky you're across it, Dowes. Thank you very much. Stay with us on 7 News. Live from Melbourne, we'll have Victoria's Easter forecast next.
It's Victoria's biggest night of entertainment.
It's gonna be fun.
The greatest lineup of stars from music, TV and comedy come together.
Live television, what could go wrong?
Whatever you do, don't get overexcited and touch Larry.
The Good Friday Appeal, today on 7 and 7 Plus.
At Spotlight, we believe life's what you make it. And we know that things don't have to cost a lot to mean a lot. So we're here to help you create it, decorate it, and celebrate it for less. All backed by our bargain guarantee. At Spotlight, it's what you make it.
When accidents happen, you question everything.
Will I lose my job? Who will earn the money? What do I do next?
You call GMP Law. We ensure you recover physically and financially because we fight to get you 100% compensation in the minimum time possible. That's what we do, and we're damn good at it. And it's why there are no fees unless you win. Call GMP Law today. 100% expert, 100% compensation.
I was going through the menopause and I really wasn't feeling great about my hair.
Plan to 39 has definitely made a difference to me.
My hair, it started to feel thicker.
It's lovely to have one less thing to worry about.
Plan to 39 caffeine shampoo for hair over 40.
I love Sunrise because you can make delicious dishes like these. I think that's my favourite. Maybe all of it's my favourite.
Taste the Sunrise difference.
This Thursday and Friday with Sportsbet, get a second chance on your same game multi. That's right, if it doesn't win, get up to $50 back in bonus bets. Only with Sportsbet.
Imagine what you could be buying instead.
Want to relieve inflammation and symptoms of mild arthritis? Try Blackmore's Omega Triple 150s from Chemist Warehouse. Each capsule contains 900 milligrams of omega-3, which is three times more than a standard fish oil capsule, to relieve inflammation and symptoms of mild arthritis. Plus, it's a naturally sourced fish oil with no odour or aftertaste. Blackmore's Omega Triple 150s is just $33.99 at Chemist Warehouse. Live, look, feel well at Chemist Warehouse.
This weather report brought to you by Travel Marvel. Freedom to explore.
Welcome back. Taking a look at the Easter weather now in Melbourne. It's 20 outside right now. We have a high risk of showers and heavy storms this afternoon. On the radar, it shows much of the rain has cleared this morning, but there is more rain building to our northwest. Thunderstorms this afternoon could produce 20 to 40 millimetres of rain. Rain and thunderstorms are wrapping around a low to our west. The activity has now cleared northwestern Victoria, but should continue this afternoon through the south and the east. Looking at the rest of the long weekend, it is turning cold in Melbourne. Showers tomorrow, just 18 the top. Sunday and Monday, tops of 15. That is all from Seven's Melbourne newsroom for now. Our major Good Friday bulletin coming up at the special time of 7 p.m. Stay with us now as we head to the live coverage of the Royal Children's Hospital. I'm Blake Johnson.